Good morning and Jai Hind, dear students. So, in our syllabus of legal studies, now we'll start unit 2, that is topics of law. And in that also the first chapter, as you can see, it is written over here that unit 2 A, law of property. Here in this chapter, we will see that what is property, what are the legal acts which do regulate the transfer of properties, and also types of properties. And what are the ways through which a property can be given from person A to person B. So first of all, we'll see that which are the laws which govern this property exchanges. So coming first to this, matters relating to property are governed by the Transfer of Property Act 1882. This you have to remember. This act is very important, that is Transfer of Property Act 1882. The object of the Transfer of Property Act, called the TPA. TPA is the abbreviation for Transfer of Property Act. Under the unit of property law, is to regulate the transfer of property between living persons. It shall be also serve as the code of contract law governing immovable property. Now, what is the meaning of immovable property? We'll see further that what is immovable property and what is movable property. So here we are talking only about immovable property, which is governed by Transfer of Property Act. The Transfer of Property Act 1882, you have to remember the name of the act along with the year. 1882 is very important. Provides clarity on the subject. It is a systematic and uniform law on the transfer of immovable property in India. Going forward, now we'll see what are the types of property. As we have just gone through the word immovable property, a lot of confusion has came across your mind that what is the meaning of immovable property. So obviously, if there is the word immovable, then there must be a property which must be movable. So properties are broadly classified into two heads, that is movable property and immovable property. All the movable properties are governed by an act called as Sale of Goods Act. This we have to again remember, it is very important that movable properties are governed by Sale of Goods Act. Immovable properties are governed by Transfer of Property Act. Again, I'm telling you people, properties are classified into two groups, that is movable properties and immovable properties. Movable properties are governed by Sale of Goods Act. Immovable properties are governed by Transfer of Property Act. Now we will see that what is property. Property hoti kya hai? So to understand it, just pay your attention where my cursor is moving right now. See here, from here. Every interest or right that has an economic value denotes property. Means kuch bhi aap rakhe hoge, jo bhi aapke paas hai, belonging hai, aur uski koi economic value hai. There must be an economic value associated with that interest or that thing. Then that will be termed as a property. Ki wo aapki property. That is your property. And then further it is explained, property is of two kinds, movable and immovable. Movable property is one which can be transferred from one place to another and is governed by the Sale of Goods Act. All the properties which are movable, as the word suggests, that movable means anything which can be moved from one place to other, that will be called as movable property. And then immovable property governed by Transfer of Properties Act is not defined in the act. However, under Section 3, immovable property does not include standing timber, growing crops or grass. Immovable property includes lands, buildings and benefits arising out of land and things attached to the earth. Now, what does this mean? It means that if you are having a, say, there is a tree in your garden, fine. So that tree, and what is it saying here? Immovable property does not include standing timber. Right, so the timber or the wood of that tree will not be termed as the immovable property, fine, but the fruits which we will extract from the tree, that can be termed as that. So going further, now coming to the text for the better understanding, these things we have already seen, that introduction to property law, types of property, that is movable and immovable. See, for a clear understanding, it is given here in Shantabai versus State of Bombay 1958 Supreme Court 532 Act. केस. दिस वॉज अ केस इन 1958, स्टेट ऑफ बॉम्बे वर्सेज शांताबाई. दीज वर द टू पार्टीज. The distinction between movable and immovable property was observed. If the intention is to reap fruits from trees, अगर किसी पेड़ से हमको फल लेके उसको transfer करना है, then it is regarded as an immovable property. Why it is regarded as an immovable property? Just understand it. पेड़ जो है आपका वो वहीं पर है, right? पेड़ जहां लगा हुआ था वो वहीं पर है, उसमें से फल निकाल करके आपने उसको यूज किया, इकोनॉमिक वैल्यू उसकी एक्सट्रैक्ट की, राइट? अब पेड़ तो वहां से नहीं गया है ना कहीं पे, पेड़ अभी भी वहीं है. द ट्री इज स्टिल इंटैक्ट एट द प्लेस वेयर इट वाज देयर, सो इट विल बी इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी. बट इफ द इंटेंशन इज टू कट डाउन द ट्रीज एंड यूज इट एज टिम्बर, इट वुड बी रिगार्डेड एज मूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी. अब आपने पेड़ को काट दिया, ठीक है, उसकी लकड़ी को अगर यूज करते हैं आप, द टिम्बर ऑफ द ट्री, देन दैट बिकम्स मूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ obviously we have moved it from one place to another. In general sense, or in a very simple words, we can understand that all types of property which can be moved from one place to another, they are categorized as movable property, and those which are not, which cannot be moved from one place to another, that is immovable property. Now the question in your mind must be arising that the fruits which we took from the tree, right, they are also moving from one place to another, isn't it? But here we are not classifying the term movable and immovable with respect to the fruit. We are not talking about the fruit, but here we are talking about that tree, because that is your property, isn't it? So in case of plucking fruits and selling it or taking it to another place, we are talking about the tree. So in that case, tree is immovable, tree is still intact over there, fine. But in the case where wood is being cut and transferred from one place to another, we are talking about the whole tree, and their tree is moved from one place to another. So that is movable, and the case of reaping fruits is the case of immovable property. Now we'll see what is transfer of property. So first of all, transfer of property means, you should understand what do we mean by this term, transfer of property. Transfer of property means the property being transferred from one person to another, or from one party to another. एक के पास property है, उससे दूसरे के पास property जाना, किस तरह से जाती है, क्या क्या उसके, what are the conditions for that, this all we will see in this topic, that is transfer. So who can transfer property? Any person who is competent to contract. What does this means? Competent to contract, this is important word. This is defined in a single phrase, that any person who is competent to contract, but it have its subheads. Who is competent? That person must be above 18 years of age. That is, it should not be, he or she should not be a minor. Secondly, having sound mind. Sound mind means should be in good, healthy mental state, right? And not disqualified by any law in force. And the law of the country should not disqualify that person from carrying out any legal processes. So the first point, that is the person must be competent to contract, it has its three sub points, that is person must be above 18, must have sound mind, and should not be disqualified by any law in force, and authorized to dispose of property, vis-a-vis owner of the property or any person authorized to sell property can make a transfer. What does this mean? And that person must have the authority to transfer the property, that is one case. And secondly, or must be authorized. Authorized se kya matlab hota hai? Jaise ki maan lijiye kisi person A hai, unke paas koi property, ya to wo khud hi property ko transfer karne ka authority rakhte ho, theek hai, aur jo ye hota hai na, this thing, or any person authorized to sell the property, ya kai bar kya hota hai ki log apne property ka authority kisi ko de dete hain. You must have came across a word, authority letter. ठीक है, जैसे पर्सन ए का एक आम का पेड़ है अगर, और वो उसको कहते हैं कि पर्सन सी जो है वो उसको ट्रांसफर करने के लिए ऑथराइज्ड है, तो उसके लिए क्या करते हैं, दे जस्ट इशू अ अथॉरिटी लेटर. द पर्सन ए इशूज एन अथॉरिटी लेटर इन द नेम ऑफ पर्सन सी, दैट यस, पर्सन सी इज ऑथराइज्ड टू ट्रांसफर दिस प्रॉपर्टी. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू यू ऑल. नाउ आफ्टर दिस we will see that how can property be transferred, that what are the limits or what are the